Hi viewers, welcome to Meghalana Nurses Academy. This YouTube channel is established to enhance the knowledge of student nurses and professional nurses. This YouTube channel will be helpful to prepare for all kind of competitive examinations like MRB, RRB, MOH, NIMHANS and etc. Viewers, please subscribe Meghalana Nurses Academy to receive the daily updates from this channel. Now we are going to discuss about MCQs on Community Health Nursing Part 5. First question, the executive organ of Grama Sabha is? Option A, Grama Panchayat. It is a basic village governing institute in Indian villages. It is a democratic structure at the grassroots levels in India. And option B is Jilla Parishat. That is the executive organ at a district level. And option C is a Grama Sabha. So the right answer is option A, Grama Panchayat, because it is a basic village governing institute in Indian villages. So the right answer is option A, Grama Panchayat. The executive organ of Grama Sabha is option A, Grama Panchayat. Second question, modified plan of operation under National Malaria Eradication Program came into force on? Option A, 1953 April 1st. Option B, 1958 April 1st. Option C, 1977 April 1st. The right answer is option C, 1977 April 1st. Because modified plan of operation was launched in 1977 with a three-pronged strategy. They are early diagnosis and treatment, vector control and IEC. So the right answer is option C, 1977 April 1st. Modified plan of operation under National Malaria Eradication Program came into force on option C, 1977, April 1st. Third question, separation of infected person from healthy person. Option A, quarantine. Quarantine is the separation and restriction of movement of person who are not ill. And option B is isolation. That is an act of separating something from other things. And option C is a migration, moving of the person from one place to the other place. So the right answer is option B, isolation. Separation of infected person from healthy person is option B, isolation. Fourth question, urban malaria scheme was launched on option A, 1971, option B, 1953, option C, 1958. The right answer is option A, 1971. Because the urban malaria scheme was launched in 1971 with the objective of controlling malaria by reducing the vector population in urban areas. So the right answer is option A, 1971. Urban malaria scheme was launched on option A, 1971. Fifth question, causative organism of filariasis. Option A, filarial parasite. Option B, Wuchereria bangrafti. It is a filarial nematode that is the major cause of lymphatic filariasis. And option C, Mycobacterium, a bacterium of a group which includes the causative agent of leprosy and tuberculosis. So the right answer is option B, Wuchereria bangrafti. Causative organism of filariasis is option B, Wuchereria bangrafti. Sixth question, revised national TB control program was launched on option A, 1992, option B, 1962, option C, 1968. The right answer is option A, 1992. Because the government of India revitalized national TB program as revised national TB control program in 1992 only. So the right answer is option A, 1992. Revised National TB Control Program was launched on option A, 1992. Seventh question, imaginary perception is known as option A, hallucination, a perception of having seen, heard, touched, tasted or smelled something that was not actually there. And option B is illusion, an instance of a wrong or misinterpreted perception of a sensory experience. And option C is a perseveration, that is a continuation or a recurrence of an experience without the appropriate stimulus. So the right answer is option A, hallucination. Imaginary perception is known as option A, hallucination. Eighth question, bleaching powder is also called option A, chlorinated lime, option B, phosphate, option C, calcium chloride. The right answer is option A, chlorinated lime, because calcium hypochlorite is an inorganic compound. It is otherwise called as bleaching powder, chlorine powder or chlorinated lime. It is used for water treatment and as a bleaching agent. So the right answer is option A, chlorinated lime. Bleaching powder is also called option A, chlorinated lime. Ninth question, according to multi-purpose health worker scheme, one male and female health worker is appointed for every dash population. Option A, 5000 population, option B, 1000 population, option C, 3000 population. The right answer is option A, 5000 population, because the concept of multi-purpose health worker was introduced in 1974 for the delivery of healthcare services at a sub-central level. This most peripheral health facilities covering 5000 population in plain areas. So the right answer is option A, 5000 population. According to multi-purpose health worker scheme, one male and female health worker is appointed for every DAS population. The answer is option A, 5000 population. 10th question, from which country the last case of smallpox was reported? Option A, India, option B, Uganda, option C, Somalia. The right answer is option C, Somalia, because the last known natural case was in Somalia in 1977. So the right answer is option C, Somalia. From which country the last case of smallpox was reported? Right answer is option C, Somalia. 11th question, all measures available to reduce or limit impairment and disabilities and minimize suffering. Option A, primary prevention, which prevents the onset of illness. And option B, secondary prevention, it focuses on reducing the impact of disease by early diagnosis and appropriate treatment. And option C is tertiary prevention, it focuses on people who are already affected by disease. The goal is to improve the quality of life, reducing disability, limiting or delaying the complications. So the right answer is option C, tertiary prevention. All measures available to reduce or limit impairment and disabilities and minimize suffering is option C, tertiary prevention. 12th question, leptospirosis is otherwise known as option A, hemorrhagic fever. It is a group of illness caused by four families of viruses. And option B, Weil's disease. It's a bacterial disease spread through the urine of infected animals. It is otherwise called as leptospirosis, which is caused by Leptospira bacteria. And option C is black water fever. It is an acute intravascular hemolysis that results from anti-malarial drug use. So the right answer is option B, Weil's disease. Leptospirosis is otherwise known as option B, Weil's disease. 13th question, causative agent of leptospirosis is option A, spirochetes, which causes leptospirosis, and option B, lysa virus, which causes rabies. Option C, spirulina, it is a biomass of cyanobacteria that can be consumed by humans and animals. So the right answer is option A, spirochetes. Causative agent of leptospirosis is option A, spirochetes. 14th question, incubation period of leptospirosis is, incubation period means that is the time interval between the entry of a microorganism and the appearance of the first signs and symptoms of the disease. The incubation period of leptospirosis is option A, 5 to 14 days, option B, 30 to 35 days, and option C, 5 to 8 days. The right answer is option A, 5 to 14 days. Incubation period of leptospirosis is option A, 5 to 14 days. 15th question, drug of choice for leptospirosis is option A, penicillin, option B, clarithromycin, Option C, rifampicin. The right answer is option A, penicillin. Because penicillin is the drug of choice for leptospirosis, which is destroying the spirochetes, which causes leptospirosis. So the right answer is option A, penicillin. Drug of choice for leptospirosis is option A, penicillin. 16th question, National Filaria Control Program was launched on option A, 1955, option B, 1971, option C, 1958. The right answer is option A, 1955, because National Filaria Control Program was launched in the country in 1955 with the objective of delimiting the problem to undertake control measures in endemic areas and to train personnel. So the right answer is option A, 1955. National Filaria Control Program was launched on option A, 1955. 17th question. Fungal infection of foot is also called as option A, athlete's foot, a fungal infection that usually begins between the toes, and option B, gangrene, that is a dead tissue caused by an infection or a lack of blood flow. And option C is a cellulitis. It's a common and a potentially serious bacterial skin infection. So the right answer is option A, athlete foot, because when fungus grows on the feet, it is called athlete foot. It got this name because it affects people whose feet tend to be damp and sweaty, which is often the case with athletes. So the right answer is option A, athlete foot. Fungal infection of foot is also called as option A, athlete's foot. 18th question. Dryness of conjunctiva of the eye due to vitamin A deficiency is option A, xerophthalmia, that is a dryness of the eye. It is a medical condition in which the eye fails to produce tears. And option B, bitter spot. Bitter spot are typically appearing triangular patches of the xerosed conjunctiva. And option C is exophthalmia, that is abnormal protrusion of the eyeball. The right answer is option A, xerophthalmia. Dryness of conjunctiva of the eye due to vitamin A deficiency is option A, xerophthalmia. 19th question, a form of conjunctivitis caused by chlamydia. Option A, trachoma, a bacterial infection that affects the eyes. And option B, petrichium, a growth that starts on the clear tissues of the eye that can spread to the cornea. Petrichium is otherwise called as web eye. And option C is conjunctivitis, that is the inflammation of the conjunctiva. So the right answer is option A, trachoma, because trachoma is an infectious disease caused by bacterium chlamydia trachomatis. This conjunctival inflammation is called as active trachoma. So the right answer is option A, trachoma. A form of conjunctivitis caused by chlamydia is option A, trachoma. 20th question. A rough and dry skin attributed to the vitamin A deficiency is option A, taut skin. It is characterized by excessive dryness, wrinkling and scaling of the skin. And option B, scaly skin. Scaly skin is a common symptom of dry skin and can occur anywhere in the body. And option C is dandruff. It is a skin condition that mainly affects the scalp. So the right answer is option A, taut skin. A rough and dry skin attributed to vitamin A deficiency is option A, taut skin. 21st question. A strong feeling of the whole organism. Option A, emotion. It is a strong feeling. And option B, motivation. It is the process that initiates, guides and maintains goal-oriented behaviors. And option C is a desire, a strong feeling of wanting to have something or wishing for themselves to happen. So the right answer is option A, emotion. A strong feeling of whole organism is option A, emotion. 22nd question. The most efficient agent used for disinfecting the large quantities of water is option A, chlorine tablet, option B, chlorine gas, option C, bleaching powder. The right answer is option B, chlorine gas, because chlorine gas is used for disinfecting large quantities of water. So the right answer is option B, chlorine gas, the most efficient agent used for disinfecting large quantities of water is option B, chlorine gas. 23rd question. The special apparatus used for measuring, regulating and applying chlorine in correct dosage. Option A, Bergfeld filter. It is a water filter made of diatomaceous earth. It is used at home for the purification of the water. And option B, chloronome. It is a part of chlorination system. It is used to introduce the chlorine to the water supply. And option C is a Horrocks apparatus. It is used to find out the dose of bleaching powder required for the disinfection of the water. So the right answer is option B, chloronome. The special apparatus used for measuring, regulating and applying chlorine in correct dosage is option B, chloronome. 24th question. Ortho-toluidine test is done to find out the amount of option A, free residual chlorine in water, option B, hypochlorous, option C, hypochloric acid. The right answer is option A, free residual chlorine in water, because 0.1 ml of ortho-toluidine solution is added into the water. The color formed is observed after 5 minutes. The formation of yellow color normally indicates the presence of the chlorine in the water. More yellow color, the greater is chlorine residual. So the right answer is option A, free residual chlorine in water. Ortho-toluidine test is done to find out the amount of option A, free residual chlorine in water. 25th question. Drinking water may have hardness in the range. Option A, 150 to 200 milligrams per liter. Option B, 250 to 300 milligrams per liter. Option C, 400 milligrams per liter. The right answer is option A, 150 to 200 milligrams per liter. Drinking water may have hardness in the range is option A, 150 to 200 milligrams per liter. 26th question. National Leprosy Control Program was launched on option A, 1955, option B, 1958, option C, 1953. The right answer is option A, 1955. Because the National Leprosy Control Program was launched by the Government of India in 1955. So the right answer is option A, 1955. National Leprosy Control Program was launched on option A, 1955. 27th question. Vitamin E is otherwise known as option A, tocopherol, that is a vitamin E or alpha tocopherol, and option B is retinol, it is also known as vitamin A, and option C is a calciferol, that is otherwise called as vitamin D. So the right answer is option A, tocopherol. Vitamin E is otherwise known as option A, tocopherol. 28th question. National Blood Donation Day is on option A, September 1st, option B, October 1st, option C, December 1st. The right answer is option B, October 1st, because on 1st October every year National Voluntary Blood Donation Day is observed in India since 1975 to encourage healthy people to donate the blood. So the right answer is option B, October 1st. National Blood Donation Day is on option B, October 1st. 29th question. Following are the methods of refuse disposal except option A, burning, that is being on fire. This is one of the disposal method of the waste. And option B, dumping, this is otherwise called as landfilling, is an old way of disposal of the waste. And option C is permuted process. Permuted process is a process of removing permanent hardness of water by using natural or artificial zeolite. So the right answer is option C, permuted process. Following are the methods of refuse disposal except option C, permuted process. 30th question. The relationship that is of extreme importance in the formation of personality is ऑप्शन ए पेरेंट चाइल्ड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द पेरेंट एंड देयर चाइल्ड इज अ यूनिक बॉन्ड दैट नरिशेस द होलिस्टिक ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए चाइल्ड एंड ऑप्शन बी सिब्लिंग चिल्ड्रन ऑफ द सेम पेरेंट्स एंड ऑप्शन सी पीयर ग्रुप ए ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल ऑफ अप्रॉक्सिमेटली द सेम एज सो द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए पेरेंट चाइल्ड द रिलेशनशिप that is of extreme importance in the formation of personality is option A parent child 31st question Indian Factory Act came in the year option A 1976 option B 1977 option C 1948 the right answer is option C 1948 because Indian Factory Act came in 1948 to consolidate the amend the law regulating labor in factories so the right answer is option c 1948 indian factory act came in the year option c 1948 32nd question the liquid that passed out of the septic tank from time to time through the outlet pipe is called option a effluent that is a waste discharged into the surface and option b sludge waste water from Household sinks, showers, and baths, but not waste liquid or excreta from the toilet. And option C is a sludge, that is a precipitated solid matter produced by the water and a sewage treatment process. So the right answer is option A, effluent. The liquid that passed out of the septic tank from time to time through the outlet pipe is called option A, effluent. 33rd question. Sanitary installation for the purification of human excreta. Option A, septic tank. It is an underground chamber made of concrete, fiberglass, or plastic, through which domestic waste water flows for the basic treatment. And option B, oxidation pond. These ponds are designed and built for waste water treatment to reduce the organic content and to remove the pathogens from waste water. And option C is a disinfection. It is the process which involves elimination of the most pathogenic microorganisms on inanimate object. So the right answer is option A, septic tank. Sanitary installation for the purification of human excreta is option A, septic tank. 34th question, causative agent of rabies. Option A, Lysa virus type 1 which causes rabies. And option B, Corynebacterium which causes diphtheria. And option C, HLTV, that is a human T-cell leukemia virus. So right answer is option A, Lysa virus type 1. Causative agent of rabies is option A, Lysa virus type 1. 35th question, who discovered anti-rabies vaccine? Option A, Louis Pasteur. He is the inventor of rabies vaccine. In 1885 and option B Edward Jenner he is the inventor of smallpox vaccine in 1796 and option C Joseph Lister he is the father of the modern surgery so the right answer is option A Louis Pasteur who discovered anti-rabies vaccine option A Louis Pasteur 36th question pulse polio immunization program started in option A 1998 Option B 1995 option C 1996 the right answer is option B 1995 because pulse polio immunization program was launched in India in 1995 and is conducted twice in early part of the each year so the right answer is option B 1995 pulse polio immunization program started in option B 1995 37th question diagnostic test for syphilis option A VDRL test is a venereal disease research laboratory test to identify the syphilis and option B Schick test it is to find out the diphtheria and option C chilling test it is to identify the B12 deficiency so the right answer is option A VDRL test Diagnostic test for syphilis is option A, VDRL test. 38th question. The term used for bad breath. Option A, halitosis, a persistent unpleasant odor in exhaled breath. And option B, gingivitis, it's the inflammation of the gums. And option C, keelosis, it is an anglostomatitis. So the right answer is option A, halitosis. The term used for bad breath is option A, halitosis. 39th question. Pea soup stool is seen in option A, cholera. It is a waterborne disease caused by Vibrio cholerae. And option B is typhoid. It is a Salmonella typhi infection that spreads through the contaminated food and water. And option C is malaria, a disease caused by Plasmodium parasite transmitted by the bite of the infected mosquito. So the right answer is option B, typhoid, because green pea soup appearance of the stool is so common in typhoid fever. So the right answer is option B, typhoid. Pea soup stool is seen in option B, typhoid. 40th question. TNAI was established in the year. TNAI means Trained Nurses Association of India. TNAI was established in the year. Option A, 1922. Option B, 1920. Option C, 1930. The right answer is option A, 1922. In 1922, the Association of Nursing Superintendent and Trained Nurses Association united together and formed the TNAI. So the right answer is option A, 1922. TNAI was established in the year option A, 1922. 41st question. Backbone of the National TB Control Program. Option A, DOTS. That is a directly observed treatment short course. And option B, District TB Program. The District Tuberculosis Center is the nodal point for TB control activities in the district. And option C is National TB Center. It is promoting, guiding and coordinating the research activities in various aspects of the TB. So the right answer is option B, District TB Program. Backbone of the National TB Control Program is option B, District TB Program. 42nd question. Revised National TB Control Program was launched on option A, 1992, option B, 1962, option C, 1968. The right answer is option A, 1992, because RNTCP was launched in 1992 in order to deal with some of the shortcomings of National TB Program. So the right answer is option A, 1992. Revised National TB Control Program was launched on option A, 1992. 43rd question. Daily dosage of rifampicin for TB is option A, 250 to 500 milligrams. Option B, 450 to 600 milligrams. Option C, 500 milligrams to 1 gram. The right answer is option B, 450 to 600 milligrams, because adult dose of rifampicin for TB is 450 to 600 milligrams twice daily. So the right answer is option B, 450 to 600 milligrams. Daily dose of rifampicin for TB is option B, 450 to 600 milligrams. 44th question. Objectives of under 5 clinics are option A, care in illness, preventive care and growth monitoring. Option B, immunization, reduction of infant mortality rate and nutrition. Option C, provision of food supply and education. The right answer is option A, care in illness, preventive care and growth monitoring, because objectives of the under 5 clinics are care in illness, preventive care and growth monitoring. So the right answer is option A, care in illness, preventive care and growth monitoring. Objectives of under 5 clinics are option A, care in illness, preventive care and growth monitoring. 45th question. Under the vitamin A prophylaxis program, the first dose is DAS international unit. Option A, 1 lakh international unit. Option B, 2 lakhs international unit. Option C, 3 lakhs international unit. The right answer is 1 lakh international unit, because if the age of the baby is less than 1 year, 1 lakh international unit of vitamin A orally should be given to prevent the blindness. If more than 1 year, 2 lakhs to be given. The first dose of vitamin A is provided at a 9th month along with measles vaccine. So the right answer is option A, 1 lakh international unit. Under the vitamin A prophylaxis program, the first dose is dash international unit. Right answer is option A, 1 lakh international unit. 46th question. In dash category of RNTCP treatment regimen, streptomycin is used. Option A, first category. Option B, second category. And option C, third category. The right answer is option B, second category. Because streptomycin is an aminoglycoside antibiotic derived from the streptomyces that is used in the treatment of second category of the TB. So the right answer is option B, second category. In DAS category of RNTCP treatment regimen, streptomycin is used. The right answer is option B, second category. 47th question. In a citrate based ORS packet, the quantity of potassium chloride is dash grams. Option A, 1.5 grams. Option B, 2.5 grams. Option C, 3.5 grams. The right answer is option A, 1.5 grams. Because ORS packet consists of sodium chloride 2.6 grams, potassium chloride 1.5 grams, anhydrous glucose is 13.5 grams, and a trisodium citrate and a dihydrate is 2.9 grams. So the potassium chloride is 1.5 grams only. So the right answer is option A, 1.5 grams. In a citrate based ORS packet, the quantity of potassium chloride is dash grams. Right answer is option A, 1.5 grams. 48th question. Reconstituted measles vaccine should be administered within dash hours. Reconstitution means that is a diluted. Option A, 2 hours. Option B, 3 hours. And option C, 4 hours. The right answer is option C, 4 hours. Because after reconstitution, measles vaccine should be kept at 2 degrees Celsius to 8 degrees Celsius. Any remaining reconstituted vaccine should be administered within 4 hours. So the right answer is option C, 4 hours. Reconstituted measles vaccine should be administered within dash hours. The answer is option C, 4 hours. 49th question. The temperature of ILR is to be recorded dash times daily. ILR means ice lined refrigerator. Option A, 2 times daily. And option B, 3 times daily. And option C, 4 times daily. The right answer is option A, 2 times daily. Because ILR must be monitored twice daily, at morning and evening. This is done in order to ensure that the vaccines are not exposed to temperature above 8 degrees Celsius. So the right answer is option A, 2 times. The temperature of the ILR is to be recorded dash times daily. The answer is 2 times daily. 50th question. Following are the danger signs of dehydration except option A, loss of elasticity. Option B, fever. And option C, increased thirst. The right answer is option B, fever. Because loss of elasticity and increased thirst are the danger signs of dehydration. But fever is a sign of infection. So the right answer is option B, fever. Following are the danger signs of dehydration except option B, fever. Thank you, viewers. Thanks for watching this video. Viewers, if you like this video, please subscribe Meghla Nurses Academy to receive the daily updates from this channel and click bell button for your notification. I'd like to thank all the viewers and subscribers for your encouragement and support. Thank you.